Welcome to the Star Talk Games, little boy. We got live streams and gameplays, little boy. Level up, Super Mario. Get crazy, man, Wario. We about to take over the whole planet. But my time is running out, so you better check the channel. We got a lot of information, let's get it. You want all that information? Come get it.
Very good day, gamers and YouTube people. How are you doing? I hope you're fine. Today I have 4 great topics I want to talk about. The first topic, Michael Patcher says that Nintendo Switch is the easiest console to develop for. Normally this man is negative about Nintendo. Digital Foundry reveals Nintendo Switch CPU and GPU clock speeds. Do they have the Nintendo Switch? And Analyst Yasuda believes that Nintendo Switch resolution will be WQHD in dock mode and 1080p in handheld mode, instead of 1080p in dock mode, 720p in handheld mode. The Nintendo Switch is going to use full Unreal Engine 4, not the mobile version like many people thought. Those are the topics for today. Okay, let's start with the first topic. So Michael Patcher says that he heard from his source that Nintendo Switch is easier to develop for than the PS4 and Xbox One. This sounds great. Normally, I don't report things from Michael Patcher. Why? Because he's a negative person, and I don't like negative persons. But this is great, this sounds great. I also think that the Nintendo Switch is easy to develop for. I think that's the reason why many developers want to make games for the console, many third parties. So, the Nintendo Switch is easy to make games for, easier than PS4 and Xbox One. This means games. I think the problem with Nintendo is they use different architecture, and that is not the way you have to work if you want more games. That's what I think, that's my opinion. So I think this is great that this console is going to be easy to develop for. We have to wait and see until January 12th. 3 weeks, people. 3 weeks, then we're going to see everything from Nintendo Switch. So I believe this. I believe in that this console is going to be easy to develop for. Nintendo have to do something to get third parties. Okay, let's start with the second topic. So Digital Foundry reveals Nintendo Switch CPU and GPU clock speeds. At least they say their source told them that. So I am not a technical guy, so I don't going to talk about those clock speed. But only thing I want to say about this, I don't believe this. The reason I don't believe it is because no one have the Nintendo Switch and open it to show us what is inside. If no one does that, I don't believe anything until Nvidia or Nintendo say to us what it is. And maybe those clock speeds are placeholders. It can be placeholders, it can be only for the dev kits, and it can be dev kits from way back. So when people have the new dev kit, maybe it's more powerful. So we have to wait and see. 12th January is not far away, so people, be patient. So let's start with the third topic. The Nintendo Switch is going to use full Unreal Engine 4 and not the mobile version like many people were thinking. Unreal Engine 4 display profiles show Nintendo Switch will run at 1080p medium GFX preset while docked and 720p low while in handheld mode. This sounds great, this looks great. I can't wait to play this console. It's nice to have a console that you can play everywhere you want. This is the same great AAA game. Wow. Battlefield 1 on your TV, on the go. FIFA on your TV, on the go. A full 3D Mario game on the TV, on the go. Zelda on your TV, on the go. Great, great, great. And this console used the full Unreal Engine 4. This means games. I can't wait for the full review of Nintendo Switch. Okay, like always, I saved the best for the last. And this one is a crazy one. I don't know if this one is true, but it's a crazy one and sounds great. So Analyst Yasuda believes that Nintendo Switch resolution will be WQHD to 1080p instead of 1080p to 720p in dock mode. And this sounds really great, people. If this is true, I don't know why Nintendo should go for WQHD 1440p, but if they does that, it's cool, it's great. I think it's better to go 4K, but of course, it's Nintendo we're talking about. They don't thinking only about power. They want to do something new, something great, and that's the reason why Nintendo is Nintendo. So, but WQHD is 4 times the resolution of 720p, so 1440p, and I stream a lot of games on 1440p, and I can say to you, 1440p looks great, looks really great, but 1440p on the TV and 1080p on the go, wow, this sounds a little bit too crazy. I don't know if I can believe this, but it is possible. You never know with Nintendo people, you never know with Nintendo. Mr. Iwata, when he was alive, he said with Nintendo Switch, we're going to surprise many peoples. And this is a big surprise, people. One of the big surprises, if they're going to use this. So, I can't wait for the review, people. I can't wait for the review. Thank you for watching. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, thumbs up and feel free to leave a comment behind, because I want to know what you think about those topics. And of course, I leave a link for you under this video so you can read everything for yourself. Take care, be positive, peace.
Thanks for watching, thanks for your time. Thumbs up for the video, comment and subscribe. You better hit the button, come and follow the tribe. With every few is love, so I'll see you next time. Let's get it on.